never say.
So this one happened quite recently. I was just at home chilling. I get a notification on my phone that somebody sent me a message on Instagram. So I open it up to see what it is, and some girl had sent me a DM about me instead of sending it to somebody else. They sent me two of my Instagram posts along with a message saying, "He's not cute, but he has a great personality." Thank you for the observation.
Oh my god!
This one happened on Twitter. This girl, I liked her tweets, I thought she was pretty funny. She was always liking my tweets, and she did post a tweet saying, "Somebody slid in my DMs, I need new friends." Because she had liked a lot of my tweets, I immediately slid in there saying, "Hey," to which she says, "Not you."
Here lie Squidward's hopes and dreams.
This actually happened in the summertime. I was seeing a girl, things were going pretty well. I'd taken her out a few times. One day I sent her a meme, and it was this meme right here, the Steph Curry basketball one. She read it and said, "I ain't no hoe." So I cleverly thought I would change Ho to her name, which was Chloe, because it fits perfectly, right? She says, "Great meme, AJ," and things carried on. But I'm scrolling through Twitter, and then I see, "Ha ha ha, this idiot keeps texting me even though I ignore him, and he just sent me this." You can imagine my response to that. So I did learn the hard way not to pursue a girl fresh out of a relationship, because it's only going to end terribly. Okay, I was seeing this girl, things were going pretty well from what I thought, but I could sort of feel things were off, and then she just texted me saying, "Hey, I can't do this anymore, I'm just not over my ex." I said, "Okay, that's cool, thanks for being honest, I had a lot of fun." And on the subject of being honest with each other, I just thought I'd let you know that before you went on vacation, we had to get out that night. I tried to stay up all night so I could take you out for breakfast in the morning before you got on your flight. I thought that would have been really nice. And she texted back, "That's so sweet. I would have loved that. I honestly did see us having a future together and everything. I promise I wasn't leading you on, but seeing him again brought it all back.
I am having a very bad day. I am in no mood. This today is one of the worst days that I've had in a long time."
So the only context for this one that I'm going to give is, me and this girl, I thought we were friends, they obviously wanted a relationship, and every time I tried to tell them, "Hey, I'm not really interested," they would just say, no, "I'm cool with being friends, I'm not interested," but would aggressively try and trap me into a relationship. Like, this got to the point where some of my friends would say to me, "Hey, is everything okay?" And I'd be like, "Oh yeah, it's cool, I'm just, I'll have a back off a little bit." But she never did. This person was just aggressive. So one day, I tweeted a picture. It was this picture here, and the joke was supposed to be, "Hey guys, look at how flexible I am." This girl went insane. So it's 4 in the morning when she sees the tweet, and she just starts blowing up my phone. And because it was so late, I didn't answer. And then I get 3 texts from her. "Bro, what the f- is this? You need to f***ing explain yourself. Wake the f*** up." That's at 4:05 in the morning. Wake the f*** up, are you serious? I don't know what made her think she can talk to me like that. But because she's blown up my phone, I'm just typing to my friends on my laptop, DMing them. And my friends, they're kind of glad that I'm finally getting rid of her. So I decided to just post a tweet, and I said, "Who up? Smash like."
Interior crocodile alligator, I drive a Chevrolet movie theater.
Which she immediately says, "I just saw your fucking tweet." So at this point, like, I've gone to work, I'm busy, and I come home, I say, "Okay, I'm just gonna block her." I did block her off everything, but I didn't know how to block somebody on iMessage. I didn't, and that was basically my downfall. So the next few days, she just says, "Hey, wow, I was testing if you blocked. I didn't know how to, but I would have if I knew how to. Can you please talk about this?" And proceeds to keep calling, I'm not picking up. So eventually she just says, "I miss you, I'm really sorry for everything."
10 seconds later.
"Oh my fucking god, AJ, you are a piece of fucking shit. I can't believe I ever talked to you. F*** you. You deserve all that's coming for you. Wow, you're a piece of I can't believe you'd about me. You're fake as hell. You deserve 1 second of my time. I never thought we were a thing. Liar. I'm literally way too fucking hot for you, and you know that shit. LMFA. You wasted your own time, bitch. I'll never understand your fucked up logic. I was your friend. I always thought of you as my friend. Someone I could laugh with. It's a shame that you think it's fun to fuck with people's emotions and then play victim. You knew exactly what you were doing. Guess your dad was fucked up emotionally. You know, me and my dad are actually on great terms. Not only did I frame this picture of him at my football game for Christmas, I also got him one of these. A nice AJ poster. Link down below, baby.
Meanwhile,
you're the biggest fucking hypocrite I've ever seen. It's fucking disgusting. All the times you talk to me about God, and now look how you fucking act. It's childish. You said yourself you can't put a Bible verse in your bio because it would make you look like a hypocrite. Damn, you was right, King. I fucking feel bad for you, man. Hope you get the help you need, or your life is gonna be miserable. I wasn't really interested in talking, I'm about the action, so I sent a nice game of my name.